Hi friends, welcome to another video today. And today's topic is the heel work on the right side. So some of you might wondering, yeah, cool, but that's not really useful. That's correct. So in IGP routine, you don't have the dog walking on your right side, but it doesn't matter. So we're training dogs, we love training dogs, and we want to keep our dogs happy and educated. Let's say educated. We just want to exercise with our dogs, have fun with our dogs. And I think that's a possible exercise you could do just for fun. It's not, like I said, it's not really useful for trials, but just to do some cool stuff with your dog. And I'm going to show you today how I personally build it up to walk on the right side. For this purpose, again, I have my marker board. It's from Martin System. And yeah, the dog knows that marker board already. I have some videos, just check out my channel so you can see how I built a love for the marker board. And when I have love for the marker board, I can use it for different exercises, bark and hold, healing, object guarding, for monitoring. There's a lot of useful exercises you can use that. And in theory, walking on the right side will basically look like this. So for this purpose, I have built a little bit a swimming pool. So when we walk on the right side, I place my marker board here. So the dog knows I have to go on the marker board. And on the right side, there's a fence. So the dog is forced to walk straight because he can't go like this or like this. So basically, I stand here. I'm gonna lure my dog a little bit on the marker board, and I mark that, and maybe I can start walking. Yeah, we have to see that today. Like I said, I have the marker board, I have a fence on the right side, so the dog has to go straight. And yeah, just gonna show you how I build it up. All right, here I have my German Shepherd with me. He knows the cluck cluck board or the marker board, and at first, just let him go. He goes to the marker board, and I mark that with my clicker. I feed him a little bit, or I can also throw it a little bit away so I have time to go to my marker board. So now I'm just gonna wait a little bit. So you see the dog's thinking, okay, I have to go to the marker board to get my reward, the food, or whatever it might be, a ball. I'm just gonna shape it a little bit by operant conditioning. So the dog goes right straight in the perfect position. I mark that, I pay the dog with a little bit food. And you can also do it a little bit different. So like this, you stand next to the marker board, you could help the dog a little bit with luring. So I throw a little bit of food away again. I take out my food, I can lure the dog a little bit. So you see he doesn't like the lure. And I'm gonna pay in position. That's also a possibility you can do. But I like to work with operant conditioning. So I throw a little bit of food away. Just gonna stand right next to the marker board. The dog comes, goes straight into position. He looks at me. And I'm just gonna mark that and pay the dog with some food. So the dog got it really quick, which is, I think, really impressive for the first time. Let's see if you can go a step forward. So dog goes in position, looks at me. Now he's sitting. Now I can start with one foot stepping forward, and let's see what the dog does. So you see, the dog's looking up to me. While I take one step with the right foot, he comes with me in the good position, and I mark that, and I pay the dog with some food. Again, I stand right next to the marker board, let the dog come by himself. He goes in the position. You can also help him a little bit in position with your hand in the beginning. Then we take one step. Dog's looking up, coming with me. I mark that, throw some food away to get some time to go back. And let's see how far we can go. All right, dog's in position. I help him a little bit with my hand. Then I start walking slow. You see the dog's looking up. and he found his position right next to my leg, which is really good. And what's also important in the beginning, that you have the fence or something that the dog cannot walk, or the dog has to walk straight, so the ass is not going away from you. Let's do it again. Start walking really slow. Dog's looking up to me. And he did really, really good. So it's really impressive. But that's also something that oftentimes people forget. They want to go too fast, they want to go too far too fast. So that's why I do a lot of basic stuff, a lot of boring basic stuff, till the dog really loves, like the marker board or the clicker or something else. Because when I have a good foundation, I can go later really fast in my exercises. So that's why it's really important to have a good basic understanding of the dog from the basic exercises, like the marker systems or positioning boxes or marker boards. So later it's a lot easier for the dogs to do new stuff. So what do I mean with boring stuff? It's not boring for the dog, because when you pay the dog, sometimes you give food, sometimes you give a ball, it starts the gambling. The dopamine is very high in the dog. But what I mean with boring, it's for the dog handler or for us as trainers, it's really boring stuff, because it doesn't look really fancy. It's nothing you can show to other people, because people are always asking, what do you do 1 year with your dog? And I say, I build the foundations, and the foundations are everything in dog training. So that's what I mean with boring stuff. It's not boring for the dog, it's just boring for us as trainers, because it's nothing fancy, it's nothing that looks really cool. But as I said, later in training, the exercises will all come together and they go really fast. So if you have any questions, please write it down in the comments and subscribe to my channel to not miss the upcoming videos. And I hope to see you guys in the next video. Till then, bye bye.